Merry Christmas, beloved. I'm always so blessed when I read the story of Jesus' birth from the Bible. It seems as though new revelation from the scriptures jump off the pages every time I read it. Luke 1:31 says, "And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus." Because of Jesus' birth, nothing is impossible for you anymore. Verses 37 through 38 say, "For with God, nothing is impossible." Then Mary said, "Behold, the maidservant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. I realize that everything God does, including the creation of the world, begins with words. Think about it. He spoke a promise to Mary in the above verse, and then we read the fulfillment of that promise in Luke 2:11. "For unto us is born in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." God wants us to know that Jesus can be relied upon to keep his promise. God's word always comes to pass. Have you ever noticed during your daily study time that everything in the Bible was written for a purpose? Even the smallest detail that most of us skipped over for years suddenly, one day, takes on a stronger meaning? That happens to me a lot. In fact, it happened again today as I was rereading the first two chapters of Luke. My heart was focused on the phrase, "keeping watch," in Luke 2:8. "And there were in the same city, in the same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night." We need to keep watch, keep awake, and be vigilant. Notice that the shepherds were not sleeping under a bush when the angels came to announce the birth of Jesus. They were alert and watchful, caring for their sheep. They had a responsibility to guard off any wolf, bear, or lion that would come by looking for a late night snack. In the same way, you and I must keep alert and be vigilant to guard any attack of the enemy. We have a responsibility to stay alert so that we can skillfully use the Word of God in prayer. In fact, the only way we can pray effectively is when we diligently keep watch. This is what Jesus teaches us in Mark 13:33 through 37. Being watchful does not mean we walk around fearful. It means that we stay in communication with the Holy Spirit throughout the day so that He can give us up-to-the-minute instructions to stop the plan of the enemy. When you are spiritually awake, you're in a position to hear instructions and respond to the leading of the Holy Spirit. You'll be able to recognize the tactics of the enemy and, in the name of Jesus, pull down all the strongholds. Instead of being on the defense after the enemy's attacks, you can use Jesus' name to block the plans of the enemy and stop him before he can steal, kill, or destroy anything that belongs to you. No matter what the weapons or evil plan the enemy dreams up, you can know how to defeat him every time. Isaiah 54:17 promises us that no weapon that is formed against you will prosper, and every tongue that will rise up against you in judgment, you will condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, says the Lord. You have God's word on it. Be encouraged during these trying times we are living in to do what Jesus tells us to do in Mark 13, verses 33 and 37. Take heed, watch and pray, for you don't know when the time is. And what I say to you, I say to everyone, watch. Well, God bless you guys. If you were encouraged today and would like to donate to our ministry, simply go on to gordonministries.org and click donate. I love you in Christ Jesus and am praying for you today. Merry Christmas.